All right, Stephanie Haney's here to tell us what's clicking in Cleveland. You had me at Machine Gun Kelly.
We're going to get to Machine Gun Kelly here in a minute. First, you know, as we have that additional case of coronavirus confirmed in Stark County, the governor's recommendations yesterday are expected to become an order within the next 24 to 36 hours, and people are talking about his approach.
We can
so
do that.
DeWine has been saying that we shouldn't panic and that he's taking rational action to stop the coronavirus from spreading in Ohio. But not everybody is on board with that. We have some people saying that this is just over the top and he's actually causing panic with these recommendations and the soon-to-be order to keep crowds out of big events. DeWine, however, is not backing down with this. He is saying that the goal here is to stop deaths. Some people, however, questioning methods on the other side, saying that why aren't we there yet with closing schools K through 12? And people are wondering what makes schools different from large events and colleges and those things happening remotely. So we are talking about this in our new Facebook group. You can find that at facebook.com/groups/3whatsnew, and you can join us there and be a part of that conversation. All right, moving on to what's happening in the radio world. ESPN Cleveland's Tony Grossi is back on the air as of this morning. Grossi was suspended, of course, as we know, for being caught on a hot mic 2 weeks ago when he referred to our Cleveland Browns quarterback Baker Mayfield as a derogatory term for a little person. It is no secret that those two have not gotten along from the beginning. Grossi was anti-Baker since before he was even drafted here. This obviously crossed the line, though. Grossi called that mistake his fumble on the Really Big Show today, saying the experience has been humiliating, traumatic, and a learning experience. And of course, at the time, he did apologize to Little People, Good Karma Brands, the Cleveland Browns, Baker, and anyone else affected. All right, now we're gonna get to our hometown guy from Shaker Heights, Machine Gun Kelly. He's doing his part to help Cleveland slang get explained to the world in a video for Vanity Fair. He started off with Sweetest Day, which we all know about, but literally nobody else celebrates. And by the way, he's not a fan.
Someone just woke up in October and was like, this is a holiday, because I have a girlfriend today.
Can't say that I blame him, you know, he's got a good point there. All right, for those of us here who don't even know about it, Cleveland also has a pretty legitimate public transit system, but we don't call it the train. This is what we call it.
The Rapid. The Rapid is the train. We've had some weird times on the Rapid, but also great term. Like, everyone goes on the Rapid when I want to go downtown for St. Patty's Day.
I personally prefer the trolley, which is free, by the way. And if you're a fan of Coke or Pepsi or Dr. Pepper or whatever, you'll appreciate this one.
Pop, don't start this argument with me. Don't get mad when I say I want pop. And be like, it's soda. It's mother pop.
It feels very strongly
Whoa.
About that. Yeah. I am totally a pop person, by the way, always. Jay, Betsy, how do you feel?
I'm going to go with pop because that was...
Yeah, or you get the wrath of MGK.
Jeez.
Don't call it soda
or
actually,
MGK.
Because I've lived all over, every time I move and I say pop in the Northeast, they look at me like, what are you talking about? What do you want? And the Sweetest Day thing, absolutely. The rest of the world has no idea what it is.
They don't. They're missing out, though. Let's just celebrate love.
Right.
We like
you know?
It.
Definitely.
It's good here.
Thank you so much, Steph. Appreciate it.